In this video, we look at a couple of problems that involve Ohm's law. So first of all, if you take a look at this circuit that we have here, it contains a current source of 2 milliamps and a 10k ohm resistor. And we want to calculate the voltage that's across the resistor. Also, this symbol here, which you haven't seen before, G, stands for conductance. And we'll talk about what that is and solve for it. And then also the power that's absorbed by the resistor PR. So first of all, remember what this symbol tells us. This symbol is a current source, an ideal current source, so we have this much current, 2 milliamps, flowing in the direction of the arrow, and we have that amount of current no matter what the voltage is across the current source. Okay, that's the voltage current definition of an ideal current source. This amount of current no matter what voltage is across it. So we know that there's 2 milliamps flowing through this part of the circuit where the current source is. Also, because there's only a single path for current to flow, there's 2 milliamps throughout this entire path. So up here, through this part of the circuit, through the resistor, and then back, there's 2 milliamps. Now, we'll prove why that's so in a future lecture, but for right now, just know that when you have a single path, the current's the same in that single path. So knowing that the current through this 10k ohm resistor is the same as the source current, 2 milliamps, we can calculate the voltage across that resistor by just doing, come over here, we can find the voltage across that resistor, KVR, just by Ohm's law. Okay, we take the resistance, 10k, okay, 10 kiloohms, and multiply that times the current, which is 2 milliamps. Okay, so again, from Ohm's law, voltage is just resistance times current. Okay, and then k is 10 to the plus 3, milli is 10 to the minus 3, so those cancel out and you just get 20 volts. Okay? All right, now conductance, which is symbolized with a G, conductance is just the reciprocal of resistance. So remember, we talked about how resistance is the opposition to current flow. Well, conductance is a measure of how well something allows current to flow through it. Okay, just the reciprocal of resistance. So in this problem here, it's just going to be the reciprocal of 1 over 10k ohms. Okay, so that just equals 0.1. And the unit of conductance is Siemens. Okay, so S, which is short for Siemens. Also, another unit that you'll sometimes see for conductance, okay, is mohs. Okay, Siemens is the more contemporary unit for conductance, but you know, an old school unit is mohs. Okay, so either one is fine. And actually, it's kind of funny that the symbol used for mohs is an upside down sigma. So it's an upside down ohm symbol. Kind of humorous. I guess I've been doing this too long. I think that's funny. But anyway, what's left in this problem is finding the power absorbed by the resistor, so PR. And remember, there's three different expressions that you can use to find power absorbed by a resistor. There's voltage across times the current through. There's also, you can use current through the resistor squared times its resistance. And then also the voltage across the resistor squared divided by its resistance. Okay, any of these three will work for the power for a resistor. So I'll just take one of them. I'll take this one here. We just plug in 20 volts. And 2 milliamps. And we get that the power absorbed by the resistor is 40 milliwatts. Okay, remember, resistors can only absorb power, like friction in the mechanical system. Okay, so we've answered all three items. We found the voltage across the resistor, we found its conductance, and also we found the power absorbed by the resistor. Let's do another problem. This next problem, you can see, is right here, where we have a toaster, and we want to find how much current is drawn by the toaster that has this amount of resistance, 10 ohms, and it has 120 volts across it. And then after we find the current, we want to find, well, how much energy is expended if we toast for this amount of time, 3 minutes, and then what does it cost us if the power company is charging us 13 cents per kilowatt hour. So let's take a look at this problem. Now, here's a circuit that represents the problem. The 10 ohms represents the toaster. Okay, toaster has a resistance of 10 ohms, so we're just going to represent it as a 10 ohm resistor. And then here's the 120 volts. Now, you know, any toaster I've ever used, I always plugged into a wall, and that's AC voltage. But we're just going to pretend that that 120 volts is a DC voltage. Okay, so as we've talked about, current in a circuit like this, it's going to flow from the plus side, the higher voltage end side of the source, to the lower end voltage side of the source. Okay, because again, we define current as the movement of positive charges. So positive charges are going to be flowing, as you see here. So the polarity of the voltage across the resistor, right, the higher end is going to be on the top side where the current enters. And excuse me. We can find what that current is by just Ohm's law. Okay, the current flowing is just going to be the 120 volts divided by 10 ohms. Again, this current's going to be the same throughout the entire path, okay, because it only has a single path to flow. So just like the previous problem, current's the same everywhere in that single path. So there's going to be 12 amps. Okay, 12 amps flowing through the toaster. So now, to find energy expended, well, that goes back to what we've seen before, where the energy expended is going to be an integration from an initial time to some time t of power. And we know that power is voltage times current, so we can plug in here 120 volts. And 12 amps, okay, dt. Okay, so now, okay, we're going to assume, you know, t0 of 0. 120 times 12 is 1440. Okay, now, see, I left this upper limit out for a moment here because I wanted to make a point that, remember that voltage times current, that's power, which is in watts, and then a watt is a joule per second. Okay, so it's important to remember this because when we put in our limit here, we want our limit to be in seconds, right, because we want seconds to cancel out here so that we're left with units of joules. Okay, so a common error is that students will get the units wrong. You know, in a problem like this, they'll put 3 here. Okay, but then you have minutes and seconds, right? So you won't get that cancellation. So you got to convert 3 minutes into seconds, so 60 seconds in a minute. So 3 minutes is 180 seconds. Okay, so watch out for that. That's a common error. So now it's just going to be that we evaluate 1440t from 0 to 180. And if you plug in 180 there, you'll get an answer. that the energy expended by our toaster is going to be 259,200 joules. Okay? All right. Well, last thing, let's find how much that would cost us. And as I mentioned in a previous video, power companies like to charge on how many kilowatt per hour that we're using. So we're told that the rate is 13 cents per kilowatt hour. So we have to take our kilowatts, okay, which is 1.44 kilowatts, and convert that to kilowatts per hour. So to do that, we have 3 minutes, 60 minutes in an hour. Okay, so that comes out to 0.072 kilowatt hours. Okay, and then to find how much, it's just going to be 13 cents per kilowatt hour. All right, so this times 0.072 kilowatt hours. All right, and you see you're left with cents, and it comes out to just about a penny. Okay, 0.936 cents. Okay, so about, it costs you about a penny to toast with this toaster for 3 minutes. Okay, so that was just a few problems utilizing Ohm's law.